Before starting the video, I would like to tell you something about IBPSguide.com. In their website, they provide a daily free question which help you to boost your preparation either for banking or SSC examination. Also, you can check out their test series which has high standard question with a detailed solution, and at the end of the each test, we provide with smart analysis that how well you performed, which are the area you must work on, and also test series are available in both language, that is Hindi as well as English. It is accessible on both desktop as well as mobile app, whichever suits on you. For more information, you can visit estore.ipsguide.com. Now let's move towards our video.
Hello everyone, welcome to IBPS Guide. I am Kashish Goyal, your reasoning guide, and today it's all about confusing statement in puzzle for SBI PO 2019. So before proceeding toward the question, I would like to request you all, please do subscribe to our channel and do like our video and do share it with your friends. So the statement first, or you can say the confusing statement number one, is box B is placed two boxes above A. So what actually this statement means, that if you have somewhere a box A, okay, so box B is two boxes above. Two boxes above means this is the first box above A, then it will be the second box. So what actually students do, that it will write down like this A, then leaving two boxes, then they will place the B. It is not the two boxes above, it is three boxes above, because this will be the second box above A. So there you must have B, clear? Or you can say box B is placed two boxes above means there is one box between A and B, clear? Okay, like this. If A is here, leaving one box, then it will be B. It will be the second box above A. Yes or no? Clear? Now, second confusing statement, that box B is placed two boxes below, same as it is. When it is two boxes below, then if it is A, leaving one box, then it will be B. Okay, clear? So these are the first two confusing statements that we actually see in the box based or floor based. Okay, same applied to the floor based. Clear or not? Clear? Now moving on to the next. So third confusing statement, there are two boxes placed between A and B. So it is very simple. Now they are saying there are two boxes. So if they are saying two boxes between A and B, it can be like this. If A is above, then leaving two boxes, it can be B. Or B is above, leaving two boxes, then it can be A. Clear? So it means if you write down, if you want to write down as a point, then A, then 2B, then it will be like this, arrows. Because B can be above A or B can be below A. Clear? Because they have just said there are two boxes between A and B. Got this? Now, similarly for the floors, there are 2 persons lives between A and B. So again, same thing. This is applicable on both box and floor base. Clear? Like this. 2 person between A and B. 2 person between A and B. A can be above, A can be in the bottom. Clear? Now let's see the next confusing statement. So fourth confusing statement. Number of person lives between A and B is same as the number of person lives between X and Y. Okay, so this is for the floor base, and it is also applicable on box base also. Clear? Like, see, if the number of boxes placed between A and B is same as the number of boxes placed between X and Y. So what they actually want to say, that whatever the number of boxes or person between A and B, suppose if there is only one, then between X and Y there should be only one. Clear? Yes or no? Clear? Like this. Okay, if you see, there you have A, there you have B. So between A and B there is only X, then between X and Y there is only B. So one person between the both cases. Now in this, if between A and B there are 2 persons, then between Y and X there is also 2 persons. Clear? So what it actually means, if the number of person between A and B is 1, then between X and Y is also 1. Clear? Now fifth statement. Number of person lives between A and B is 1 more than the number of person lives between X and Y. Now what it actually means, if between A and B we have 2 persons, okay, then it must be one greater than the between X and Y. So between X and Y there must be only one. There must be only one. Clear or not? Because between A and B is one more than the person between X and Y. Clear? Like this. If between X and Y there is only 1 person, so between A and B there are actually 2 persons. One more. In this also, between X and Y there are 2 persons, so between A and B there are 1, 2, and 3 persons. One more. Clear? Now sixth. A lives above B, and this is also valid in boxes, that is box A is placed above B. So above B, what it actually means, suppose if you have like this a stack like this and B is somewhere here, so A is above, so A is above means only this, no, not only this, A can be here, can be here, or can be here, it must be above B, but it not mentioned where, like this. If B is here, A can be here. If B is here, one person living, A can be here. Then living 2, A can be here. Then living 3, A can be here. Then living 4, A can be here. It can be anywhere above B. Clear or not? Clear? Now moving on to the next statement. Now, A lives immediately above B. Now, this word placing the value of A on the above B on the immediate. That is, if B is A, then on the immediate above, it will be A. Clear? There can't be any other floor. Clear? Like this. If B is here, then A must be here. Immediately above means just above. Now, 8th one. At least 2 boxes are placed above A. Similarly, for floors, at least 2 person lives above A. So, what are they saying actually? That there must be 2 person above. So, if A is here, so there must be at least. At least 2 means you can't have only 1 above A. Clear? So, you have at least 2. So, if A is here living, this can be possibility. Then, it can be. Because they are saying the least. Least must be 2 and maximum can be anything. Like this. A is here, there are 2. If A is here, 3. If A is here, 4. Then 5, then 6, then 7. Clear? So, at least 2 means you can't have only 1. A can't be here. This is not possible. So, A must be on the 6th floor. Clear? Now, moving on to the next statement. Statement number 9. At least 2 boxes are placed below, same as it is the previous one. There you have above A, but they have below A. So, below A there must be at least 2 and maximum it can be anything like this. Below A there is only 2, then if you are taking A on the 4th, then there will be 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, it is all possible. But A can't be on the 2nd, because if A is on the 2nd floor, then only one person below him, but it is not possible because they are saying at least 2. So, at least 2 means minimum 2 there must be below A. Clear? Now, 10th. Not more than 2 boxes are placed above A. So, this is little different from previous ones, because when they are saying there are at least, but now they are saying there are maximum 2 above A. So, above A maximum 2 means it can be 2, it can be 1, or it can be none. Clear or not? Because they are saying not more than 2. So, it can be 2, 1 or 0 like this. Above A, 2. Above A, 1. Above A, none. Clear? Now, moving on to the 11th. Not more than 2 boxes are placed below A. Not more than 3 person are leaves below A. Same thing. Now, they are certifying the maximum positions. So, they are saying not more than 2 boxes are placed below A. So, below A, there can't be 3. There can't be 3 because they are saying only 2. So, it can be 2, it can be 1, or it can be none. Clear or not? Like this. Below A, none. Below A, 1. Below A, 2. Clear? So, they are saying not more than 2. So, it means A can't be possible here, can't be possible here, can't be possible here. Because if A is on the 4th, then it will be 3. But they are saying not more than 2. Clear? Now, 12th. Box A placed between B and C. A lives between B and C. Now, such type of statements will also come in the sitting arrangement that I have already teaches you. Okay? That I have already teach you. So, go through those videos also. Clear? Go through the confusing statement in the sitting arrangement too. Now, A is between B and C. So, what it actually means? Like suppose if you have this one. So, suppose B is here and C is here. So, A must be between B and C. So, A can be here or can be here. Or most of the students do like this. B, C is here, then A they make here. So, this is wrong. Because they are saying between. Between can be anywhere between B and C. Clear? So, like this. If B is here, C here, A can be here. If C is here, B here, A can be here or can be here. It is both possibilities are there. Now, if B is here, C is here, then A can be here or can be here. Clear or not? Clear? So, between anywhere, it can be A between B and C. Clear? Now, moving on to the 13th. A lives exactly between B and C. Now, this word defines something that is, will be exactly. Exactly means space between B and A and C and A must be equal like this. If B is here, C is here. So, leaving 1, 1, A can be here. Or you can say leaving only this one, A can be here. Or you can say like this also. Clear or not? because in all the diagrams you can say A lives between B and C like this. C B, then it is A. C B leaving one here it will be A, and this one leaving two, A will be here. So it is exactly between C and B. So what it actually means that distance or space between B and A must be equals to A and C. Clear? Now moving to the next statement. If they give the vacant floor or vacant shelf, then 2 person lives between A and B, or 2 boxes are placed between A and B means. Now see, vacant, if there is any vacant floor, suppose if we have 8 floors, okay, and they are saying one of them is vacant, and they will say there is 2 person between A and B. Suppose if A is here, so they say there are 2 person between A and B, so B can be here or B can be here. Now how? Because one floor is vacant, so it can be possible that on these two there must be person living. But if you place A here and B here, and there must be 2 person living between them, so one floor must be empty, then it will form the 2 person between them. Clear? Like this. If they are saying A is here and B is here, and they are saying none position between A and B is vacant, so there must be 2 person. But when they are saying considering one is vacant between A and B, so if one is vacant, then there will be 2 person living between A and B. Clear? Now 15th. At most 10 boxes are placed in the shelf, or at most 10 floors are there in the building. So at most mean maximum 10, or minimum it can be 1. Minimum it can be 1, because maximum it is 10, then maximum minimum can be 1. Like this. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, like this. Clear? It is very easy. Now, the trending one. This is very trending right nowadays in the test series examples or in the exam also. That what we have, there are 6 floors with 2 flats are given such that B is exactly to the east of flat A. Clear? So what it actually means? Suppose if we have 6 floors, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we have 2 flats on each. But what are they saying? That flat B exactly to the east of A. So if A is here, then it must be B here. Because if you talk about the direction, it will be north, south, east or west. So B must be to the east of A. So if A is here, then B must be here. Clear or not? Clear? Like this. So it will be A here and B here. Clear or not? Okay. Clear? Now see. This is the flat A and this is the flat B. Now there is also some statements given in the question that no one lives to the west of A. So to the west of A means A must be at this point, and no one lives to the east of A, it means A must be here. Or you can say if A is here, then in the flat B there must be no one. Clear or not? Clear? Got these points? Now next one, 16th. In a days or months, okay, in a day or months type puzzle, A was promoted 2 days after B, or A was promoted 2 months after B. Clear? Whether it is in the day or in the month, they are saying A is promoted after B and it is 2 days. So if B is promoted on Monday, suppose if B is promoted on Monday, then A must be promoted on 2 days after that, it must be on Wednesday. It must be A. Clear? Like this. If B is on the Monday, A must be on the Wednesday. Clear? And if B is in the February, A must be in the April. Clear or not? Clear? 2 days after means second day. Now, if we consider none of them promoted any one of the day or month, okay, so it means like this. If you're taking A on Tuesday, okay, if you're taking A on Tuesday, so just write down the different statement that B is promoted 2 days after A. Clear? Now B is promoted 2 days after A. Now see what they are actually doing, that if they consider Thursday is no one promoted, okay, so there will be space of 3, because they are saying 2 person must be promoted. So this person and this person, because this is an empty place, so there will be 3 days between them, because on Thursday there is no one promoted. Clear or not? Clear? Same has gone in the month. If A is in the March, then B will come in the July. Because if you consider April is no one promoted, then it will be May and June, there will be 2 person promoted, then it will be B. Clear or not? Clear? Now, 17th one. Number of person promoted before A is same as the number of promoted after B. It is very simple. I have already told you in the so many puzzles I have told you that before and after means the person before A must be equal to the person before after B, like this. Okay, promoted before A is 2, so after B is also 2. Clear? Now before A, 2, after B, clear or not? Clear? So if you have any doubt, please let me in the comment section box. Okay, if you have any doubt, please let me in the comment section box. And please, if you like it, do subscribe to the channel and do like the video and do share it with your friends. Clear? And please visit estore.ips.com because on the occasion of Eid, we have making more discount in our platinum pack. Okay, just go on to the estore.ipsguide.com and purchase that as soon as possible, because after it will be not possible to give in that price. Clear? So thank you so much. Keep watching and keep learning.